Good morning. Today we are going to review Simple Harmonic Motion as a part of the AP Physics C Mechanics curriculum.
Flippin' physics!
An object is in simple harmonic motion if the acceleration of the object is proportional to the displacement of the object from equilibrium position, and if the acceleration of the object is directed toward the equilibrium position. For example, a horizontal mass spring system on a frictionless surface has a free body diagram which looks like this. The force normal is up, the force of gravity is down, and the force of the spring is directed to the left toward the vertical dotted line, which is called the equilibrium position or the rest position, where the end of the spring would be if the block were at rest. Bobby, please sum the forces in the x direction on the block and solve for the acceleration of the block.
Sure. The net force in the x direction equals the force of the spring, which is negative because it is to the left, which equals mass times acceleration in the x direction. The magnitude of the equation for the force of a spring is the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position, or k times x. Divide by mass, and we have the acceleration in the x direction equals the negative of the spring constant divided by the mass, all multiplied by x.
Great. Notice how the acceleration is proportional to the displacement from equilibrium position. In other words, as the displacement increases, the magnitude of the acceleration also increases. And because of this negative, the direction of the acceleration is opposite of the direction of the displacement from equilibrium position. In other words, the acceleration is directed toward the equilibrium position, which means this equation fits the conditions for simple harmonic motion, which is why this block will continue to slide back and forth indefinitely in the absence of friction. Because amplitude is defined as the maximum displacement from the equilibrium position, the maximum acceleration of a mass spring system is equal to the spring constant divided by the mass, all multiplied by the amplitude. Billy, what is the equation for instantaneous acceleration in terms of position?
We know instantaneous acceleration equals the derivative of velocity as a function of time, and instantaneous velocity equals the derivative of position as a function of time. That means acceleration equals the derivative with respect to time of the derivative of position with respect to time, or what we call the second derivative of position with respect to time.
Then we can replace the acceleration in the previous equation for a mass spring system with the second derivative of position with respect to time. And we let the spring constant divided by the mass be equal to omega squared, where omega is defined as the angular frequency. We get the second derivative of position with respect to time is equal to the negative of the square of the angular frequency times position. This is the condition for simple harmonic motion. And this equation is not on the AP equation sheet. You need to memorize it. For a mass spring system, the angular frequency is equal to the square root of the spring constant divided by the mass, and omega is also equal to the change in angular position over change in time. And for one full cycle, the change in angular position is 2 pi radians, and the change in time is the period, which is capital T.
Bless you, Mr. P.
Thank you. Solving for the period gives us the period of a mass spring system, which does appear on the AP equation sheet. And I definitely recommend you know and understand this derivation. In addition, you should know and understand the derivation of the period of a pendulum, which is equal to 2 pi times the square root of the length of the pendulum divided by the acceleration due to gravity.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bobby?
We should clarify that the length of the pendulum is from the center of suspension to the center of mass of the pendulum, right?
Yes, Bobby, we certainly should.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bo?
Are frequency and angular frequency the same thing?
Bo, no. Frequency and angular frequency are not the same thing. Frequency, or lowercase f, is the number of cycles an object goes through per second. and the frequency is equal to the inverse of the period. And we've already shown that the angular frequency equals 2 pi divided by the period, therefore angular frequency equals 2 pi times the frequency. So again, no, frequency and angular frequency are not the same thing, however clearly they are related. An equation for position as a function of time, which appears on your AP equation sheet, which satisfies the condition for simple harmonic motion, is the position as a function of time equals amplitude times the cosine of the quantity angular frequency times time plus phi. Because angular frequency is in radians per second, you must use radians for phi in this equation. Speaking of phi, phi is the phase constant, or the phase shift. For example, if you look at the graph of y equals cosine theta with theta in radians, and compare that to the graph of y equals the cosine of the quantity theta plus a phase constant of pi over 2 radians, you can see that the cosine graph is phase shifted to the left by pi over 2 radians, which is also 90 degrees. That is what the phase constant does. It shifts the location of the cosine or sine wave on the horizontal axis. Billy, please take the derivative of our position as a function of time equation for simple harmonic motion.
Well, velocity equals the derivative of position as a function of time. Substituting in the equation for position gives us the derivative with respect to time of amplitude times cosine of angular frequency times time plus the phase constant. Taking the derivative, we need to use the chain rule. Amplitude is constant, so just leave that out front. The derivative of cosine is negative sine, so we have the negative sine of angular frequency times time plus the phase constant. And then we need to multiply by the derivative with respect to time of the angular frequency times time plus the phase constant, which is just angular frequency. So the simple harmonic motion equation for velocity with respect to time equals the negative of the amplitude times angular frequency times the sine of the angular frequency times time plus the phase constant.
Correct. And because sine has a maximum value of 1 and a minimum value of negative 1, the maximum velocity of an object in simple harmonic motion equals the amplitude times the angular frequency. Bo, could you now please determine the equation for the acceleration of an object in simple harmonic motion?
Acceleration equals the derivative of velocity with respect to time. So we have the derivative of the velocity equation we just determined. Amplitude and angular frequency are constants. The derivative of sine is cosine. And again, we multiply by the derivative of omega t plus phi, which is just omega. So the acceleration as a function of time for an object in simple harmonic motion is negative amplitude times angular frequency squared times the cosine of angular frequency times time plus the phase constant.
Great. And again, because cosine varies between 1 and negative 1, the maximum value for the acceleration of an object in simple harmonic motion is equal to the amplitude times the angular frequency squared. And now let's bring this all the way back to the condition for simple harmonic motion. If we rearrange the equation for the acceleration of an object in simple harmonic motion just a little bit, we can show that the acceleration is equal to the negative of the square of the angular frequency times the equation for position. Which means the original equation for position, which was given on the AP equation sheet, fits the condition for simple harmonic motion. Now let's take a look at the graphs of these equations. Position is a cosine graph, velocity is a negative sine graph, and acceleration is a negative cosine graph. And let's return back to the horizontal mass spring system and relate it to these graphs. If the block is at its maximum displacement from the equilibrium position to the right, this distance is called what class?
Amplitude.
Let's call this position number 1. The block will then move to the left and eventually be at the equilibrium position, and let's call this position number 2. The block will pass through position number 2 and eventually reach its maximum displacement from equilibrium position, or amplitude, on the left. Let's call this position number 3. The block will then slide back to position 2, and then back to 1, then 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, and in the absence of friction, this motion will never stop. This block is in simple harmonic motion. Bobby, at position 2, what do we know about the velocity of the block?
Well, according to the velocity graph, at position 2, the block will either have its minimum or its maximum value.
In other words, the magnitude of the velocity will be a maximum.
And we proved earlier it will have a value of the amplitude times the angular frequency.
Billy, what about the velocity of the block at position 1?
Actually, the velocities at positions 1 and 3 will be the same. They will both be 0. You can see this from the graph because the curve passes through the time axis at positions 1 and 3. And we also know this because the block will be changing directions at positions 1 and 3, and when the velocity changes directions, its value has to pass through 0.
Bo, what about the acceleration at all 3 positions?
Well, the acceleration at position 2, which is the equilibrium position, is 0.
You can see that from the graph because the curve passes through the horizontal axis at position 2. But we also know it because the force of the spring will be 0 at the equilibrium position, so the net force in the x direction will equal 0, so the acceleration will be 0. The magnitude of the acceleration will be a maximum at both positions 1 and 3, because the displacement from equilibrium position is the amplitude there, so the magnitude of the net force will be a maximum, so the magnitude of the acceleration will be a maximum. And we determined its value just a little bit ago. The maximum acceleration is amplitude times angular frequency squared.
Thank you, everybody. That's great. Now, an important question. Is simple harmonic motion also uniformly accelerated motion?
I don't think so.
No, if you look at the graph of acceleration as a function of time, you can clearly see the acceleration is not a horizontal line. So it is not a constant acceleration, so it is not uniformly accelerated motion.
Please remember, simple harmonic motion is not uniformly accelerated motion. Okay, class, is mechanical energy conserved in simple harmonic motion?
Yes. Yes.
Yes, because no energy is added to or removed from the system via a work done by an external force, and because no energy is dissipated via a work done by friction, mechanical energy is conserved during simple harmonic motion. Notice when the block is in positions 1 and 3, it is located its maximum displacement from equilibrium position, or the amplitude, and therefore it is at rest and has no kinetic energy. Therefore, the only energy it has is elastic potential energy. Therefore, the total mechanical energy equals 1/2 times the spring constant times the amplitude squared. And when the block is at position number 2, or equilibrium position, the only energy it has is kinetic energy, so the total mechanical energy also equals 1/2 times mass times the maximum velocity squared. This brings us to the end of my review of simple harmonic motion. Next, you can enjoy my review of equations to memorize for the AP Physics C mechanics exam, or you can visit my AP Physics C review webpage. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.